What are containers and how to manage them? We'll talk today about Docker. In order to create an application that will consist of many components, for example database MySQL or search engine such as Elasticsearch and the server, we need a way to manage all the elements. The problem is to keep the development environment consistent with the production environment. How to control what is installed on the server and how to configure, for example, a database. We can write down somewhere and then repeat the steps on the server and locally, but this can easily make a problem. For example, there are different extensions in the basic PHP package in such Alpine and in Ubuntu, not to mention Windows and Mac. Lack of a stable environment, due to differences, for example, operating system, can cause errors that will be difficult to identify because they occur only in one environment. For example, the case of a directory that is not differentiated in Windows and in Linux it does. The solution to the problems is Docker with Docker Compose. In the beginning, you have to look for containers, that's components of our application. We can look for a suitable container on hub.docker.com, for example, we can use MySQL by docker pull MySQL command. We will need PHP version FPM using docker pull PHP FPM and Jinx to use docker pull Jinx Alpine. Each container is a separate image, just like a flash drive or CD, has a separate system and works independently. Okay, but how to configure it? Here, Docker Compose is helpful, which allows you to write down the definitions and configurations for a particular project in the Docker Compose YML file without the need to execute a series of commands each time you configure the environment. Usually, Docker Compose up made in the project directory is sufficient with the configured environment. A useful function is mapping directories and ports. When selecting env underscore file, the container searches for variables placed there for the appropriate configuration. For example, the MySQL container uses MySQL underscore database, MySQL underscore user, MySQL underscore password. What container, what variables it uses, can be found on the hub.docker.com website in the documentation after entering the appropriate container. How to relate to other containers? Simple, use names during setup. Docker creates images with internal names that are inside a given network that is created within a given project, and external names that are searched from outside the container. Name of container you can find by a command on a computer docker ps, and then enter the command line on this container using docker exec at bash content internamename. How to prepare your own painting? We can create a docker file that will contain the commands that are run at the beginning. Define the base container, for example from PHP 8.1.0 FPM. Then, using commands such as docker php ext install, add plugins, or docker run where we add commands such as in the Linux console. How to configure local settings? We create, for example, docker compose override local YML to be able to locally copy and rename to docker compose override YML and set this file gitignore so that these settings will not be sent to the server. What can we add locally? We can download containers useful in the development process, such as Mailcaker for capturing email or Adminer for browsing data in the database. We recommend you stick to the end and watch all our videos in the playlist. Check sources of this video in the description, where you can find more information. Leave the like, comment and subscribe, and share it with friends that want to improve programming skills. Finally, Kubernetes and Docker Swarm are worth mentioning. These are tools that allow you to scale containers in a production environment with the separation of multiple servers. Docker Swarm manages containers between multiple servers, while Kubernetes allows you to scale multiple instances and distribute traffic accordingly. Both services are similar to each other and are used in similar situations and can be interchangeable. A more detailed analysis of them and the principles of scaling and dividing traffic requires a separate video. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.